Hello, hello, Genial Gamer Gal here with upcoming Switch games for July 2019. The first game coming out on July 2nd is Red Faction Guerrilla Remastered Edition. Clever. This will have a price tag of $29.99 and be released physically and digitally. This remastered version of the game touts reworked graphics, shadow rendering, and lighting. The Switch also has optional motion controls. Red Faction Guerrilla is an action game set 50 years after the events of the original Red Faction game. It is an open-world game with fast-paced guerrilla-style combat that you will utilize to complete your missions. There is also multiplayer combat in which you will put your skills to the test in a variety of multiplayer modes. I've never really been into the Red Faction games, not really my cup of tea, never played the series, so I think I'm gonna pass on this one. But let me know your thoughts and if you've played the Red Faction series. Dragon Quest Builders 2, releasing July 12th. This game has a price tag of $59.99 and will also have a physical and digital release as well. This is a role-playing action game in which you gather, craft, and build your fantasy world and then defend it from monsters. There is also new content in this game, fast traveling, swimming, dashing, gliding, and a first-person perspective gameplay. You'll be able to play with up to three other players via local wireless or online, which requires a Nintendo Online membership. There are also additional recipes available with DLC and save data from your first game. I haven't ever played the first game, and I'm not completely sure about picking up this game yet. It seems a little Minecraft-esque, and I'm not really into those type of games. So maybe a future purchase, not day one. Let me know what you think of Dragon Quest Builders 2, and if you've played the first one and your thoughts about picking it up. Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, The Black Order, is releasing July 19th at a price tag of $59.99. This game will also have a physical and digital release. This is an action role-playing game in which you assemble your team of superheroes to battle Thanos and the Black Order. There is local and online multiplayer support. As always, Nintendo Switch Online membership with online multiplayer, and it supports up to three other players. I will be picking up this game day one, as my husband and I like to play these types of action games together. Let me know if this is on your list of games to pick up as well. Raiden 5 Director's Cut is releasing on July 25th, has a price tag of $29.99, physical and digital release. This is a shoot 'em up arcade game which has three different game modes. Story mode, which alters depending on your performance in the game. Boss Mission, which has you defeating the boss and competing in leaderboards. And Gallery, which has character, concept, and game art waiting to be unlocked. Since this game is a director's cut, it also has exclusive levels, and it also includes voice acting for the first time in this game series, and also supports 1 to 2 players offline. As far as I know, it doesn't sound like that there is an online mode for co-op play. Shmups are always fun, and I think I'm going to be adding this to my list to pick up as well. However, I don't think it will be a day one pickup, probably a pickup in the future. Wolfenstein Youngblood, releasing July 26th at a price tag of $39.99. This game is available digitally only. Even if you purchase a quote physical copy, you will only receive a download code in the box. Which in my opinion is dumb. I mean, why even bother? But yeah. Anyway, Wolfenstein Youngblood is an action-adventure game in which you can play solo with an AI companion, or you can also team up with a friend. This game touts being the most open-ended Wolfenstein experience to date. In this game, you will level up, explore, and complete missions to unlock new abilities, weapons, gadgets, and cosmetics to fit your playstyle and customize your appearance. I honestly have never played a Wolfenstein game and don't really know if I want to start. It doesn't interest me too much, so I might pass on this one. Let me know what you think of the Wolfenstein series of games. And last but certainly not least is Fire Emblem Three Houses. This game is releasing on July 26th, has a price tag of $59.99, physical and digital release. There is also a Seasons of Warfare edition priced at $99.99 and has extra goodies such as soundtrack, art book, and steelbook. I'm honestly not sure if this is still available. These special editions usually sell out pretty quick. In Fire Emblem Three Houses, you are a professor that has been invited to teach at the Officers Academy. You must choose one of three houses to teach. This choice will affect where you stand when the land becomes engulfed in war. You're going to command a party of warriors in this turn-based tactical RPG that has you fighting on a grid-based battlefield. Hire and equip new battalions to strengthen your units. I do plan on picking up this game, however, I'm not sure if it's going to be a day one purchase because I have a lot of games on my list that I would like to purchase and my poor wallet. So I have to keep my budget in mind and kind of see which games I want the most and put them on a priority list, I guess. But let me know if you plan on picking this game up day one or as a future pickup. All right, that wraps up this episode of Upcoming Switch Games. Let me know which games you plan on picking up, which games you're going to pass on. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Check out my other gaming videos. And as always, thanks for watching and have a good one.